see, there is no such restriction. Therefore, I got my disciples married. They criticized me that I have become a married man. Anyway, I wanted at least to regulate. That is required. Dharma viruddha kamasmi. Krishna also says. Now, a married man also can be brahmachari. If a married man stick to one wife and before sex, if he takes permission from his spiritual master, then he is brahmachari. Not whimsically. When the spiritual master orders him that now he can be a child, then he is brahmachari. Srila Virago Acharya, he has described in his comment that there are two kinds of brahmachari. One brahmachari is naistik brahmachari, he doesn't marry. And another brahmachari is, although he marries, he is fully under control of the spiritual master, even for sex. That is, he is also brahmachari. So, why so much restriction on the sex life? The people do not understand throughout the whole world. They are captivated by sex life, especially in the Western countries. Pungsang sriyo mi thuni bhava mi tam. Material existence means a desire of sex life, both man and woman. Pungsang sriyo mi thuni bhava mi. Not only in human society, in animal society, in bird society, everywhere. That is material life. Tayor mitha hi jayavanti mahu. And when they are united for this purpose, the man and woman, we are already attached to the material activities, then our attachment becomes more and more strong. Then out of this attachment, atah griya chetra sutapra vittai, janasamoho ayam ahamamiti. In this way, being united, then they want griha, apartment to live together. Then they want some land. Formerly there was no service. The grihastha used to produce the food grains from the land. Neither there was factories or big offices to get job. One had to produce his own food from the land. So simply apartment will not help. I must require some land for eating. Griha-kshetra, suta, then we desire for some children. Suta-apta, then friends. Suta-apta. Atakrihas khetra sutapta vittai. But all these establishments can be maintained by money only, then money. Then in this way gradually janasya mohoyam. We are already bewildered. We are attached to this material world. But when we are united, man and woman together, our attachment for this material world becomes increased. Janasya mohoyam aham mameti. Material world means I am this body, and in material in relationship with this body, everything is mine. This conception. They forget altogether that nothing is mine, even this body is not mine. Even I am not mine. Everything is Krishna. That is what. Unless we get to that status of life, that nothing belongs to me. This body also belongs to Krishna. I as spirit soul belong to Krishna and everything belongs to Krishna. Then we become liberated. Tapasya brahmacharyena. This human form of life is meant for tapasya, to learn how to become detached from this material world. And the beginning is this brahmachari life. Brahmachari gurukule vasan danta. Danta means self-control. That is real teaching. Either a grihastha lives, if a grihastha lives, even he has got wife, he does not, one side, according to Vedic civilization, there is no sex life except for begetting a nice child. And that also with Garbhadhan samskar. In other words, whimsically sex life is completely stopped in Vedic civilization. There everything under regulation. Therefore, brahmachari means how to control the senses, to keep under his own control. Not that I am now sexually inclined, I must have immediately sex. Dant. That is taught, just like in our society, even Grihastha. He is also under restriction. And what to speak of brahmachari. But we should always remember that this human life is meant for controlling the senses. Athātam brahma jigyāsa. It is simply meant for inquiring about our spiritual life. That is perfect civilization. Therefore, brahmachari means you are living at the direction of guru, guru's hitam. And guru's hitam, how he can be simply thinking of benefiting the spiritual mass. Unless that position comes, nobody can serve Guru. It is not an artificial thing. The brahmachari, the disciple, must have genuine love for Guru. Then he can be under his control. Otherwise, why one should be under the control of another person? Therefore it is said, Acharan Dasavat. Dasa means servant. Not only servant, but menial servant. Menial servant means just like the sweeper, the cobbler, like that, they are called menial servant. In India there is system, the sweeper class is different, the cobbler class is different, and domestic servant is different, the barber, he is also servant. Different. The washerman, he is also servant. So, nicha means just like the washerman or the barber or the cobbler, they are less than the domestic servant at home. They are sudras and they are considered less than the sudras, panchama. So, a disciple is expected to live in Gurukul, or Gurukul means at the center of Guru, Nichava, menial servant, Nichavat, Acharan, Dasavat, Nicha, Guru, Sudhira, Sahuja. This can be possible when one is very thickly related with the Guru. Otherwise, ordinary relationship will not go. One who has got actually the conviction, jasya prasadada bhagavat prasada, one who is convinced that if I can please my Guru, then Krishna will be pleased. This is called sudhira, full faith. Jasya prasadada nagati kutobi. And if I displease my Guru, then I have no place. In this way, of course, Guru cannot be a false Guru. False Guru has no such thing. If one Guru is genuine and the disciple is genuine, then both of them are benefited and they go back to home, back to God. थैंक यू वेरी मच।